Yes, so good morning, Rishi. I think others will join in a while. Let us wait for them.
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning. Yeah, so Muzamiru and Rishi, this subject is already 9:37. I would like to begin the session. If the remaining classmates will join, then it is fine. Otherwise, let us continue. As such, it is design engineering session. And your fourth semester is design 1B part, right? And particularly, we are meeting for the first time in conducting the session related to design engineering. Right. So almost you are aware about all the canvases and all in the design engineering 1A also. But what are the changes are there in the 1A and 1B part that I will in general I will discuss in the beginning. Then we will see the today's topic, whatever is assigned in the today's slot, right, by the course coordinator, that is PMSI. So let me share my screen with you. Yeah, I hope this is visible. So this is the timetable the course coordinator has prepared. Domain: reverse engineering, emphasization phase, ideation phase, product development phase. And I think yesterday PMS sir might have started this particular thing, which is nothing but the customer and user revalidation part. Is it like that? Have you attended that session yesterday?
Sir, attended, but no session is attended. Means there is on right now no teams has selected their project titles.
None of the team has selected the project. Is it like that?
Yes, sir.
What you can do is you can carry forward with your existing design engineering project if you would like to carry forward. And the same team can be continued. Whether the teams are formed, okay, third, seventh team change, continue karo, chhu karwana.
Yes, sir.
Are you going to continue with the same team, right? Okay. So if you are going to continue with the same team, you can carry forward the same project if you are comfortable with it, right? It is not required that in any, all the semester you need to change the title and you need to work on that and so and so. Only the thing is, in design engineering 1B, 1A was A to Z. We have understood the design thinking by one particular process. Now, design engineering 1B part is reverse engineering. Reverse engineering is the main objective of the fourth semester. That means whatever the design title or design project you have thought of, whatever the design project you have thought of, product level you need to start with. You need to disassemble the product and see that how the product is assembled. Right. For example, you have selected, let us say, home automation. Then whatever the home automation based projects are available, their application, their hardware related stuff, you can study, right, in the reverse order. That means whatever the product is available, see its features, for getting those features, how they have been incorporated in the form of software, in the form of hardware, using which front end, that is with the which application and which controls they are controlling the that features and how they have incorporated them, and for getting those features, which are the hardware component, what are the sensors and the other steps are also required, right? That also we need to study, and that part is known as the reverse engineering, going from the product level implementation to the design idea. That part, that is Z2A, going in the reverse order, is known as the reverse engineering part. And the canvas is whatever you are supposed to prepare in the fourth semester, they are mainly based on the reverse engineering. The third sem canvas is whatever the canvas is you have prepared in the third sem, right? You need to keep the reverse engineering objective in mind, and the same canvas is you are supposed to prepare in the semester four. Right. If you are not changing the design title, if you are not, changing your team, then the same title you can carry forward. Start with the product level thinking. Go to the scratch level. That is basically the reverse engineering. While doing so, preparing the empathy mapping, ideation, product development, and the remaining other canvases, right, LNM and all, right. For making all these canvases, keeping the reverse engineering in the mind, you need to go for the design thinking development process in the reverse order as well. That means we had a vague idea in the third semester, and then we have thought about the project, right? We have come up with some title. Now the title is already built in our mindset, right? Now what we need to do is we need to think from the product level and go to the sketch. That is basically the idea of the semester four. Our today's topic is this customer or user revalidation, reject, redesign and retain. That is the decision making process part of the product development canvas. So you are already aware, de.gtu.ac.in, there all the canvases are available. Let me open this product development canvas, and there customer revalidation part is this one. Customer revalidation part is this one, right? So where you need to go to the customer, actually, presently it is not possible to go into the field, but you can have any digital meeting. Can ask to, if your topic is generalized, you can ask to the people in the society, right? Basically your stakeholders, those who are going to utilize your product. To them you need to reach by whatever the means, and you need to ask, you need to share your product features, product experience, right? Basically this thing, product experience, product function, product features, and what are the components you are going to build up your project with. And based on their discussion, stakeholders based, their feedback, we need to write down this particular part. That is, once you are finished with your feature set, test those features, components, experiences with the customer or user, if the features functions are useful to them, or whether they are enhancing their user experience, whether they will be feel better with the existing product or not, what extra you are providing to them, or how you are making their task simpler, right? That kind of decision you need to take. And for making this decision of reject, redesign and retain, you need to discuss with the end users or the customers, and that part is known as the customer revaluation part. Once you have written n number of things based on your discussions, what you can do is, if you do not get the stakeholders or the customers, whatever your team members are there, two people should be the sharing their project with the third person, and third person can be the customer. The third person mind should go in a direction of they are the end user. In that way also you can prepare this particular part of the customer revalidation, right? And based on those revalidation part, we need to decide whether we need to redesign, or we can say modify some of the implementation ideas, whether we need to retain the ideas, or whether we need to reject, right? So based on this, three R are to be decided. Post customer revalidation, reject those functions or features that the customer didn't find useful, redesign those that the partially useful, and retain those which met the bar, which meet the user requirement. Iterate with this until all the function and features are accepted, right? So E has been spaced, it is wrongly been spaced. So basically are accepted, that is what is the. So whatever the guidelines or the 3 to 4 sentences are written below each and every title, they are considered to be as guide or hint to prepare that particular part of that canvas. This was the only part I wanted to share with you, because it is being assigned in the today's date and today's slot. If you find any difficulty in understanding this, then you can ask. If you have any difficulty related to your own project, you can ask. Otherwise, I think it is fine, right? From my end, I have shared whatever I wanted to share with you in the today's session. Now it is over to you. If you have any queries, any doubts in the design engineering process, in the design engineering title, or in the today's topic, you are feel free to comment. You are feel free to ask.
Sir.
Yeah, who's Amin?
Does it mean like in every semester we shall have to change the title, or today this 40
no,
semester?
No, who said?
No, I was just asking, because in the third semester we got a title, then fourth semester we were asked at another title.
Yeah.
So does
it's
it
not required?
Okay.
It's so required to change the title in all this. I would suggest that if you work on the same title, you can
come to
a gradual process in each semester. Right?
Yes, sir. And another thing is, if we continue with the same title,
university has suggested both the approaches. If you would like to change the title each semester, that is also possible. And if you would like to retain the title, then also it is possible. So do not worry. If somebody is asking you to change the title, you can say that we have changed our mindset while thinking related to our project in the reverse engineering manner.
Okay, another thing is, if you keep with the same title, then how will the canvases differ from the previous canvases to this canvas? Because I see the same things.
As I told you, the previous semester, you went with the chronological order. You started with the idea, you had your thought process up to the product.
Yes, sir.
In this semester, start with the reverse method. You need to start with the product level and go to the idea. So what you will find is, whatever the design process you have thought of in the last semester, and whatever is actually available presently in the market, in the society, right? How they are matching with each other, that fine tuning you can develop with the help of this two different approaches. And that is what is the difference, right? You have a product, you need to start with the product and go to the scratch level. In the last semester, you started with the scratch and ended up with the product level, right? That is what is the difference. So basically, in this semester, you need to refer to some of the articles, you need to refer to some of the literatures which are suggesting the actually available hardware, software, ultimately the product level. And based on that, you can find out, you know, the users.
Okay, sir, that was my question.
Yeah,
yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Rishi, anything from? Yeah, 19 no, is also coming. All right, so the process is clear. So now, such only two or three students have attended this session. Now it is my request as well as your duty to inculcate whatever we have discussed in last 20 to 25 minutes, right? That you should share with your teammates first, right? And then with your entire class as well, right? In the simplest manner, so that it will be helpful to all these, you know, second year students. How was your exam?
Yes, sir.
Digital system design and network theory. And other all sorts of things. It was good, right? Paper was simple. Hey,
yes,
man.
Sir.
Mohsin.
No, sir.
No, you. Came paper agru lagyu?
Yes, sir. Time was so low, emerged, and I couldn't write any of the answer correctly in digital system design.
Why? What is the reason?
Sir, our time was running so fast. I was able to complete the circuit. I wasn't able to complete the circuit.
Okay. What about you, Muzamil? How was your paper?
Yeah, I think it was good.
It was good, right?
Yes, sir.
And there were enough number of options. You had to write only of 56 marks, right? So that way you do it, attempt the. Okay, all right. Due to the present situation, we need to continue with this mode only, online mode, right? So we'll be meeting for conducting the sessions in this MS Team based system only, right? Otherwise, the institute had you know, planned to start the offline education after your exams, but presently the COVID cases are more in even in Anand district, right? So in the you know, keeping the common interest in mind, institute decided to continue with the online mode for second year, third year, even for the final year as well. Presently, only the first year students are there on campus due to their Viva exams, right? For all the others, we need to keep our temperament and tempo up, and we need to remain concentrated in online sessions only, right? So we are already habituated with the MS Teams and the other stuff. Keep the fresh energy, keep your temperament up, be regular in attending all the online sessions. Because today, chali hue aap log regular lecture chale se us karwa. That morning we need to attend all the sessions. Pass on this message to all the students in your class group. Thank you very much from my end today. This is what I wanted to discuss.